My name is Lukas Shumway. I'm a first-year graduate student here at Johns Hopkins University. We're in the Cellular Molecular Developmental Biology program.
Luke is using the fruit fly eye as a model to understand the mechanisms that control color vision.
Knowing how the system works will help us be able to either more easily diagnose what's going on or help find a way to prevent it. So that's why you need that core science there. I am dissecting a retina from a fruit fly. But yeah, it's definitely something that once you finish it and you get your final product, like whether it be staining or if you're just using retinas for tip, then it's something that's really pretty rewarding. And then you get to tell your friends, hey, I dissected a retina today. Looking at retinas, I mean, obviously there's like total blindness, color blindness, stuff like that. So, and other irregularities. And if you understand like how it's working, then you can possibly come up with ways of fixing color blindness or being able to like mediate total blindness. And that's really cool. I'm originally from Niagara Falls, New York. Neither of my parents had gone to college. There's myself and then I have an older sister. We were the first ones in our family to go to college. When I went, I swam through high school and I really wanted to go to a school where I could swim. That didn't happen because a school down the street from me, Niagara University, offered me a full tuition academic scholarship, so you don't turn that down. It's actually something where it's okay to not know what you want to be when you grow up, even when you're in grad school. It's definitely something that as you go through it, you're going to change. Your interests will change, and that's something that's very characteristic of scientists. The really loving research part probably comes more if you get into a project that you instantly really are drawn to and really, really like. When I do an assay and run the data and I see it produce this nice graph of what's going on, it's like, okay, so this is what's happening. Like, this is what this data says, and I can see that this is happening. So that means that that could lead to this. And it's a real fun kind of like thought experiment. When you see data, even if it's bad data, it's saying that this isn't how something works. And that's very cool too. Definitely, I mean, this is just general college advice. Definitely, if you can, take courses in high school that will contribute to college credit. I started coming out of high school, I started with 26 credits. So I was technically a sophomore. And so your AP classes, probably, especially if you're going into the sciences, they will not cover your intro sciences. Just accept it. You don't want them to anyways. You want to get back in and take your gen bio, take your gen chem, because you might have like really understood it and stuff in high school, but when you go to college and then they explain it in the college aspect, it's going to be completely different. But taking those classes, it prepares you for how a college course is going to go.